हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू इंडियन जुडिशियल सर्विस। टुडेज वी आर डिस्कस हियर क्वेश्चन नंबर 341 टू 360। दिस इज द पार्ट 19th ऑफ टॉप 400 एमसीक्यू ऑफ कोड ऑफ क्रिमिनल प्रोसीजर। इफ यू आर लाइक दिस वीडियो प्लीज क्लिक ऑन लाइक बटन एंड प्लीज सब्सक्राइब अवर चैनल। नाउ कम टू द पॉइंट हियर, क्वेश्चन नंबर 341। व्हेन the approver willfully suppresses the material fact or gives a false evidence, the option A here, the court itself has inherent power to proceed against approver. The court does not have inherent power to proceed against approver. The police can take action against him and no on the request of police the court take action against the approver. If the court find that the approver giving the false evidence or giving the suppressed material fact, in such time court have itself inherent power to proceed against approver. So option A is correct here. Now question number 342, any effort to settle a dispute or end claim by applying a pressure through a criminal prosecution. Option A here, should depend on the present criminal system. Option B, should depend upon the discretion of court. Option C, should be a depreciated and discouraged. Option D here, not should be depreciated and discourage. So here answer is, it should be depreciated and discourage. Now question number 343, in the police does not take action on complaint in respect of cognizable offense, the complainant, option A, has right under section 90 190 of CRPC to complain before local magistrate. The complainant has no right here, right? And in the second option, no right under section 190 of CRPC, the complainant before local magistrate, has right under section 290 of CRPC to complain before magistrate. Option D, has right under section 390 of CRPC to complain before magistrate. So here answer is option A. If the police cannot take action on complaint in respect of cognizable offense, the complainant has right under section 190 of CRPC complain before local magistrate. Here magistrate taking the cognizance here. Question number 344, whether suspicion is a substitute for proof of offense. Option B, not a substitute for proof of offense. Option C, a relevant factor for a proof of offense. Option D, not a dependent factor. So it is clear here, the suspicion is not a substitute for proof of offense. Now question number 345, the inherent power of the court to order a joint trial of cases is exercised when it appear to the assume that some common question of law or fact arises in both proceeding. Option B, the right to relief claim thereof is in respect of the same transaction. Option C, right to relief claimed thereof arising out of the same series of transaction. Option all of the above. So in this question answer is here option all of the above. Where the question is law, where the right to relief claim in respect of same transition like question of law, and third year point, the right to relief claim thereof arises out of the same series of transaction like question of law and end of justice. So in these transaction the high court taking these inherent power under section 482. Now question number 346, in which of the following case it was held that the section 164, so in 164 which things is provided, the recording of recording of evidence by the magistrate, by witness oblique accused, both persons. So in this section, use any person word, use any person. So strictly compel with the option A, Babu Bhai Udaisin Parmar versus State of Gujarat 2007, Rajesh Rajan Yadav versus CBI AIR 2007, Naveen Chandra versus State of Uttaranchal AIR 2007, Amrit Singh versus State of Punjab AIR 2007. So in this question, option A is correct here, Babu Bhai Uday Singh Parmar versus State of Gujarat. In this section, the court held that the section 164 of CRPC is required to be strictly compelled. It is very important. Section 164 of CRPC required to be strictly compelled with. Now, question number 347. In 2007, which High Court order no arrest of women before sunrise and after sunset? So it is clear here, option B is correct. Rajasthan High Court in 2000 declare that no arrest of women before a sunrise or after sunset, and in this such case the Justice Deepak pronounce this sentence. Question number 348. Which section of CRPC provided that in no case of aggregate of the consecutive sentences, the pass against an accused shall be exceed 14 years? So now option A here, 31, section 31 of CRPC. Option B here, section 51 of CRPC. Option C here, for section 34 of CRPC. Option D here, section 41 of CRPC. Before giving answer, we are now discuss here section 31 of CRPC, section 51 of CRPC, section 34 of CRPC. Section 31 provided that the sentence in cases of conviction. Cases of conviction. So in this section, the provided that the sentence in the cases of conviction and conviction of several offense at one trial. So here, one more than one offense are here. Several offense at one trial. One trial. So this things is provided in section 31. So here the magistrate giving the sentence, who is trialing the case, and maximum 14 year, and this 14 year not restrained it, the magistrate, and who giving the maximum punishment is 7 year and unable to give. No, a magistrate like us, chief judicial magistrate, giving the punishment up to 7 year, but he may give the 14 year of sentence according to this section, up to 14 year. Now section number 51 of CRPC, the 51 provided that the search of arrested person. So here, search of arrested person. So a person who is arrested by the police, and the police having the power to search that person. Now section 34 provided that the withdrawal of power by High Court or state government. So here the withdrawal of powered by High Court oblique state government, not Supreme Court. Here it is state government. And section 41, this is very famous section, very important section, where the police officer arrest any person without warrant, in the case of cognizable offense. Cognizable offense. Or such cognizable offense is presence in the, here presence is must be there, presence in the police officer. So in this section, the police officer can arrest any person without warrant where the cognizable offense happening in the presence of police officer, and the police officer getting the credible information about the happening of cognizable offense. So in these things are provided in section 41. So according to our question here, the section of, in which section of CRPC provided that the no case of aggregation and consecutive in sentence, so no consecutive sentence passed against the accused shall exceed 14 years. It is provided in section 31. Question number 349. The procedure for trial before a court of session is provided under section, option A here, 260 to 265, option B here, 238 to 250, option C here, 251 to 259, option D here, 225 to 237. So now we are discuss here which things is provided in these sections here. Chapter 28 provided that the court of session taking a trial, in between this section 225 to 237. Now chapter number 29, so chapter number 29 provided the trial in warrant case. So trial here, trial in warrant case, and the section between 238 to 250. So this chapter divided into two part here. First, police report, on police report in warrant case. So in police report warrant case, these sections are related here, 238 to 243, plus these two sections are important because there are judgment in 248 and 250. So these are the related to the warrant trial on the basis of police report under section 238 to 243, plus 248 and 50. Now police on, now warrant trial in complaint. So here in complaint, 244 to section 247, means here 244 to 247 is related to the complaint case of warrant trial, and there is the addition of these three important section, 249 plus 248 plus 250. So this 249 is especially for the complaint case where the complainant is absent. So what procedure is taken by the magistrate? So this section is very important. Now come to the chapter number 20. Chapter 20 of CRPC. This section is extended to 251 to 259. And this is the trial of summon case. The trial of summon case. So summon case, the special feature is the magistrate not framing the charge, and this is that for saving the time of the magistrate. That's why this procedure is there. Now, chapter number 21. This is summary trial and it extends 265 and this is summary trial. Summary trial is the procedure followed by the summon trial, summon case, yes, summon trial. There is also not framing of charge, and these are the petty cases, and that's why there is no need of framing charge. So according to this question 349, the session court trial is provided under section 225 to 237. Option D is correct here. Now question number 350, the offense committed under which section of IPC is not compoundable under section 320 of CRPC. First important thing is, under what is the 320? So 320 is a providing the provision, it this section is deal with the compounding of offense. Compounding of offense is like a withdrawal of offense by the complainant or by the parties. So which IPC offense? Option A 352, option B section 353, option C section 354, option D 355. In this question there is a doubt between this, but not compoundable, so answer is here option B or C, because 352 is clearly provided in Indian Penal Code, and the section, according to section 320 of CRPC, the list shows that section 352 is compoundable and 355 is also compoundable, but 353 and 354 are not compoundable. So answer between these two points. Now question number 351. When there is a dispute between the two court, the relating to a exercise of a jurisdiction is the criminal matter and said the occur. So there are the two courts in criminal matter jurisdiction. The said court are under the subordination of different high court, and these courts are under the subordination of different high courts. The matter shall be decided under section 186 of CRPC by Supreme Court, the higher court of larger state, higher court of having more judges, and the court within the whose local limit of the appellate jurisdiction the proceeding first commence. So it is clear here, not Supreme Court, not larger court, states court, high court, and not more bench of high courts. So answer is here option D. The court within whose local limit of appellate jurisdiction proceeding first. So where the proceeding first started, that court having the jurisdiction to take trial. Now taking option question number 352. In which of the case, which case was held where the identity of victim is not to be disclosed even the judgment of court? Option A, Sasi Khan vs. CBI AIR 2007, Dinesh vs. State of Rajasthan AIR 2006, the Naveen Chandra vs. State of Uttaranchal AIR 2007, none of the above. So it is here, the option here, option A, Dinesh Chandra vs. State of Rajasthan AIR. In this case, the Rajasthan High Court decided that the identity of victim is not to be disclosed even the judgment of court. So the even the judgment of court, there is no need to disclose the identity of victim. That's why we are always reading the rape victims and they are the virtual name, like Nirbhaya case. So Nirbhaya is the virtual name of victim, and it is also protected under section 228A of IPC, Indian Penal Code 228 of IPC is protected, this section also, this provision also. Now question number 353. Within the meaning of 311 of CRPC, who among the following authority has power to order a person to give a specimen signature and handwriting? Option A, magistrate of first class, option B, magistrate of second class, option C, session judge, option D, any magistrate. So here important here, so under section 311A provided that the authority has power to order to give a specimen signature or handwriting to any person. So answer is here, which authority? So magistrate of first class having a power, not second class, and there is no need of session court and any magistrate. So option A is correct here. Now question number 354, in camera trial referred to open trial? No. The trial broadcast of television? This is impossible. No. The trial which public and press are not allowed, or summary trial? So this is not summary trial. In camera trial refer that the trial the which public and press are not allowed to present in trial. So option C is correct here. Camera trial is generally we found that the cases related to husband or wife or rape cases or the offense against the women's generally. So there is no need of the public and the reporters and any other persons. And sometime the prosecution or defense also excluding. If there is no need, if there is need, the only advocates and the prosecution or defense are present and the party of the proceeding are present. Now question number 355. The Directorate of Prosecution, the provided provision added in the CRPC by the Code of Criminal Procedure Amendment Act 2005 shall be established by central government, each state government, CBI, RAW. CBI, this is the Central Bureau of Investigation, RAW, Research and Analyze Bing, the full form of these two things. So answer is here option B, each state government. So each state government appoint or the Directorate of Prosecution, and this things is provided under section 25A of CRPC provided that the provision of Directorate of Prosecution. Now question number 356, within the meaning of section 144A of CRPC, who among the following authority has the power to provide a carrying arms in prosecution or mass drill or a mass training with arm? Option A, SDMJ, SDM, here municipal magistrate, here district magistrate, option D, here any judicial magistrate. So in this question, answer is here option D, district magistrate having a power under section 144A. Now question number 357, the plea of bargaining, this is very important point in mains exams. According, a new chapter was added in Criminal Procedure Code 1973 by the Criminal Law Amendment Act 2005, 2 of 2006, is contained in. I already described these things here, but it is very important. Now section 265A to section 265E, option B here, section 265A to section 265L, this is L, and option C, section 265A to 265M, option D here, section 265A to 265N. So in this question, answer is here option B, this is L, very important. L means loin, very important animal. So the plea of bargaining available in option B, 265A to 265L. So if anybody is not founding my previous video, please go to the description box. There is the link of all previous videos. So in these videos I describe these things very clearly. Now question number 358. The Code of Criminal Procedure Amendment Act 2005 came into force. So Code of Criminal Procedure Amendment Act 2005 came into force. Option C is here, 23rd June 2006. Now question number 359. The chapter 21A, plea of bargaining, containing the section 265A to 265L of CRPC came into a force. Very important question. In which year the plea of bargaining came into force in CRPC? So option A, 5th July 2006. Option B, 16th April 2006. Option C, 23rd June 2005. Option D, here 23rd June 2006. So answer is here option A, 5th July 2006. The plea of bargaining under section 265A to 265L is in force in CRPC in India. Now final question of this video, question number 360. The provision related to a plea of bargaining comes under which chapter of Criminal Procedure Code? Option A, 21. Option B, 20A. Option C, 7A. Option D, 21A. So it is clear here, the plea of bargaining provision provided under chapter 21A. So thank you for watching this video. If you like this video, please click on like button and subscribe our channel. Thank you.